Welcome back. Today I am going to teach you about 6th standard science. First lesson, our food, the sub concept is preservation. What? Preservation. What is preservation? Preservation of food that we are going to talk about in this session. Now, first of all, let us know what is preservation. Preservation means it's a process of storing foods. Preservation of food means it's a process of storing. Yeah, usually what type of food items store, do you know? The foods like in our home, your mother cooks, if your mother cooks more than enough food, if the food remains, that remaining food is stored, where does your mother store that food? In a refrigerator, right? In refrigerator. And why to store it? Why to store? What happens if you leave that food in open place? What happens if the food is not stored properly? On the next day, the food gets what? Spoiled. Gets what? Spoiled. The food gets spoiled. Okay, here one thing that you need to understand. In general, farmers grow what? The grains in large quantities. Farmers grow what? The food grains in large quantities. But does the farmer who grows that large quantity of food grains eat it? No, he doesn't eat that, right? He needs to preserve it. He needs to store it. So he needs to store it for long time. For long time in future use, for future use. Okay, so the farmer, to store these food grains, the farmer should follow some methods, right? Some methods. So the method or the process of storing or the preserving the food is called food grains. Food or food grains is called preservation. Okay, here, yeah. You might have seen your grandparents making pickles. You know, you just ask your parents or grandparents that ingredients are used to prepare that pickles. And you already studied about the ingredients used to prepare different curries, right? The ingredients, are there any same ingredients used in making pickles and making curries? Yes, there will be some, obviously there will be some same ingredients, but the curry that we eat that gets spoiled on next day, but the pickles that we make that doesn't get spoiled on next day, why it remains longer time? That's, there is the people follow a preservation methods, and then they use special ingredients. That ingredients are called preservatives. The ingredients that make, some of the ingredients make the food remain for longer time, the ingredients are called preservatives. What do we call them? Preservatives. Preservatives are the ingredients, food ingredients, which helps or which makes that food remain for longer time. Okay, so some of the examples of preservatives I'll tell you, and examples for the preservatives like salt and turmeric powder, chili powder, and oil. And another method we follow, that is drying and smoking, method of preservation, smoking, sugar syrup, sugar syrup, and sometimes honey. Honey is also used as a preservative, food ingredient as a preservative. These preservatives help not to spoil the food items, and they help them, the food items remain for a long time. Let me give you an assignment that is about using these in food ingredients and the methods, food ingredients and the methods like drying and smoking, and the food ingredients like salt, turmeric, chili powder, oil, honey. You just find that the foods, you just find the foods that we preserve using these food ingredients and following the preservation methods like drying and smoking. Yes, this is an assignment that you need to do, okay? And you be prepared for the next class with full completion of your work, okay? Now, one thing, one warning to you, and not only to you, everyone, the warning is the preservatives are sold in the market, and some of them are adulterated or polluted, okay? So the polluted, they don't sell what the original preservatives, so they sell that substandard quality preservatives. We should be careful about the preservatives that we buy in the markets, okay, right? And this is a very big warning that we need to remember. Some of the packed foods, some of the packed foods are labeled, some of the packed foods are labeled with, date of MFG. This abbreviation is written, this is on the cover, the packed food means manufactured, okay? This means manufactured. So date of manufacture should be observed, okay? If you are buying a packed food, you should observe this date of manufacturing, and next date of expiry. Date of expiry. The packed food, the food must be used between the date of manufacturing and date of expiry. So that will be, that will be in good quality. And if the time is exceeded, that food will get spoiled. So we should not buy the packed foods that which date of expiry is expired. Okay, date of that expiry is crossed or expired. So, and some of the foods date of expiry will not be given. Date of expiry will not be given on some of the food items, and what will be given? Only duration will be given, okay? Only duration. How? Only duration of that best before 1 month or 2 months or 3 months, like this, you know, 12 months, like this, the packed foods, you know, the date of manufacture they give, but they don't give the date of expiry. We should see this best before, and we have to estimate that whether the food is expired or the whether the food is not expired. Then if it is not expired, we can use off, and if it is expired, we just discard it. Okay, we have to be careful while buying the packet foods in the market, outside the market. So what happens if we take the expired foods, if we eat the expired foods? That will damage our health. What? Damage our health. So be careful, beware of the foods, packet foods that you buy in the markets, in the outside shops. Okay, this is for today, and this is the last topic of this lesson, this chapter. And I hope you all understood, and you just in the next class I will be explaining about the improve your learning section. Okay, each and every lesson has improve your learning section. So in that section, what we will have, we will have questions. So we will find answers for that questions from the next class. So this is for today. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all. Last but not least, it's, you know, preparation of food items is an art. Okay, and cutting the vegetables and fruits in different designs, and the cutting of vegetables into different decorations and different designs. Cutting vegetables and fruit into designs is called vegetable carving. Okay, vegetable carving. So this is the finishing of the lesson, and you to try to make different designs using fruits and vegetables. You to try to prepare different designs using fruits and vegetables. And this is for today. Thank you. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.